Hello, my beautiful people. How are you? This is Ali Wycheck Rojo. I hope you're following your dreams, really taking those actions that you need to take towards living that joyful, fulfilled life that you deserve. I want to tell you three things that you can try right away, either if you're starting leveling up, if you're in the midst of it, or whether you're super advanced, or even if you know someone who's really trying really hard to level up and grow. When we're trying to be better, when you are trying to grow as human beings, that process hurts and that process can be challenging. Nobody said that growing and being better actually is easy. It is a rewarding, beautiful, amazing process. Like, nobody says that actually losing any excess amount of weight on your body and working out and rocking up, exercising every day is gonna be easy. It's gonna hurt, like legit, it's gonna hurt. It's gonna hurt to do those burpees. It's gonna be painful to do food prep, all of it. But you do it because you know that you are growing in the process, you're changing, you're really loving your body and you're giving your body what it needs. And exactly that's what happens when we level up. And so, hola gordito. I wanted you to think about, how are you leveling up in your life? Because for me, leveling up is not to change who you are. It's actually thinking of yourself being 100% you, but a better you. And why? Why is being a better you better? For me, being better, and I personally think that for myself, being better is knowing that I can progressively and systematically on a daily basis work on those baggage things. And for me, it's baggage. For me, it's actually taking a lot of things that don't serve me and try the clutter. So it's like leveling up for me is like essentially daily decluttering. You're working every day on taking the things that don't help you. Those things are slowing you down. It's essentially trying to run a marathon with like a really heavy 30 kilo backpack. You're not gonna go very far. But if you every day take one thing of the backpack while you're doing the marathon, what's going to happen? You're going to be feeling so much stronger, you're going to feeling so much better, and you're going to get to where you want to get to while enjoying the process. Leveling up for me is not about the outcome. I don't even know what outcome I'm going to get out of doing what I do every day, out of journaling every day, out of meditating every day, out of exercising every day, out of working on my limiting beliefs, out of working on my imposter syndrome, out of working on my business while I'm still doing a four-day consulting gig that I got to do while I'm doing all these things. I don't know where I'm going to get to, but it's the process, it's the enjoyment of feeling that I am not numb. I am doing something for myself. I am working on myself and I'm loving myself. I'm respecting myself and I see myself as someone who is imperfectly perfect, working on being better every day. That's for me what level up is. But that is my definition of level up for me. And for you, that might be very different. You know, I'm going through a lot of hurdles myself. That's why I experiment with my life so greatly, so I could clear the path for myself, but I could clear the path for you. So when it's your turn to level up and your turn to take that brave, courageous action of leveling up, you have my advice and my resources to show you what you can do. So there's three things about your ego and your limiting beliefs. Not because you're meditating, not because you're working on your body, not because you're working on your spirit and you're working on your mind, it means that you're gonna have zero egos and zero limiting beliefs. They will still show up. Not as strong as when you're starting off, but they will still show up. Like, I've been working on my very own personal growth for years. And I've always been someone like a growth seeker, always looking for growth and ways to becoming better. And even now, I still have a lot of things that pop up. And I want to explain why. There's a part of your brain called the amygdala. And that is part of the primitive part of your brain. And essentially, this primitive part of your brain has been with you forever. And it's been with us for thousands of years. But because it's such a strong part of your brain that does the fight and flight response, that is actually what is stopping you from doing those things that you are kind of want to do but be scared of doing. And your primitive brain is going, whoa, slow down, why you're doing that? That's crazy, that's just a terrible idea. So that is your primitive part of your brain, and I will actually tomorrow be launching a YouTube video on it that talks about a really cool and free technique that you can use. I've used it myself for years now, and it has helped me rewire my brain, set neural pathways for my cognitive brain to be more prominent and my amygdala, my primitive brain, to be less prominent, so I could see life very, very differently, be grateful, feel happiness, and my ego and my limited beliefs are not showing up as often. Means number one is acknowledging this ego or these limiting beliefs. Whether you're in the middle of a meditation session, whether you're in the middle of putting your shoes on to go to the gym after you haven't been to the gym for years, whatever it is, your primitive brain will step in and go, what are you doing? Why are you doing this? Why don't we go back to bed? Why don't we do this? Why don't we blah, blah, blah? And you just need to acknowledge it. That's number one. Acknowledgement is key. Elizabeth Gilbert, in her book, Big Magic, talks about how she sees these limiting beliefs or ego personality, almost like someone that you're doing a road trip with and they're sitting next to you in the co-pilot seat. It's kind of a friend, but it's an annoying friend. But you love that friend, you respect that friend, but that friend is literally sitting next to you, telling you everything that's gonna go wrong, how long it's gonna take to get on that, to that other end, and etc. And that is your ego. And you gotta acknowledge that is there. If you ignore it and pretend it doesn't exist, it's actually gonna make it worse. So number one is really acknowledging that friend that is a little bit annoying, but you know is there. And you know it is there to play a role. So if you acknowledge it, that's the first step that you're gonna take, and just continue doing the thing. Number two, show compassion. I believe, and this is my perspective, and I've told a lot of people about this when we do our trainings and coaching, is that loving your ego, loving your primitive part of your brain, loving this like annoying friend actually helps. Because if you see that as an enemy, if you see that as someone or something that is trying to stop you and actually put your lot of negative energy towards it, that energy is coming from you towards that. And you need to make sure that you're keeping that good energy within yourself. It's like, imagine of yourself like a bank account. If you take energy out of your bank account to put it into something that's totally out of you, is totally out of your control, then you're just gonna be replenishing your bank account, your energy bank account. So you gotta be using that very positively. And when you show compassion towards these ego limiting beliefs, you're actually acknowledging there is there. That annoying friend that is driving in your car with you is someone that needs love, and it's actually someone that's trying to protect you. Because your amygdala, AKA your ego, is there because it's actually trying to protect you. It's trying to keep you safe. That's the job of your primitive brain, is to keep you safe. So if you make sure that you see it for what it is, then you need to make sure that you just show compassion instead of anger or sadness or anything like that. The third thing that I wanted to do is to continue working, building your habits and routines while, number one, you acknowledge those pop-up beliefs, those pop-up ego moments, and showing self-love. You got to continue building your habits and routines even when you've done this for a very long time, even when you have progressed with those voices that pop up in your head telling you you shouldn't do this, you're not worthy, you got imposter syndrome, there is someone doing this better, someone else has already done it, they are dating someone else, what's the point of being a millionaire, what's the point of living an abundant life, there's a lot of people suffering. Whatever it is coming up for you, you gotta continue the process. Leveling up, growing, being better, becoming better, it is a task and a job that has a compound effect. I always talk about the compound effect, where you need on a regular basis work on yourself. It's not something that you do today, maybe next week. You don't get a healthy body by eating healthy maybe once a week. That can make some little changes, positive changes. But if you do it daily, if you do it regularly and consistently, change will be faster, change will stay, everything that you put energy towards changes. So again, it's the energy that you put towards this. And if you see that this ego, these limiting beliefs are popping up while you're trying to grow and level up, just keep it up. Keep up doing what you're doing. Be compassionate towards yourself. Be compassionate towards that ego. Be compassionate towards the limiting belief. Be compassionate to what your brain is trying to do for you, because it's trying to help you. Obviously, it's stopping you to doing the things that you want to do to live the life of your dreams. So that's what I wanted to share with you. And if you do want to try this technique that I'm sharing to me in our YouTube channel, go and check it out tomorrow. It's going to rewire your brain. Number two, will really stop a lot of those limiting beliefs. It will help you see the glass half full instead of the glass half empty. And it's going to give you so much power, so much gratitude on the little, small, medium, big things are happening to you while you're growing, while you're changing, while you're trying to be a better version of yourself. And that is all, my beautiful people, that I wanted to share with you today. Just remember that you are the beautiful light needed right here and right now. I love you lots. Have a beautiful morning, afternoon, evening, wherever you are. And I'll catch you very soon. Take care. Bye-bye.